Praveen ji, good afternoon and welcome, and it's wonderful to see you here. As the Secretary General of CAIT, the Confederation of All India Traders, how many traders in India do you represent and what kind of a mix do they come from?
Well, we are representing more than 40,000 trade federations and associations across country, okay. Thereby representing about more than 70 million SMEs.
70 million. This must probably be amongst the largest representation amongst any trade bodies, I would imagine, anywhere.
I hope so.
Yeah, I would imagine. And what geographical areas of India? Now, India is a very big country, as we know. I mean, it goes right from the north of India in the Kashmir and Leh-Ladakh area down south to India. And then there are many union territories as well as areas outside the mainland of India. Where does the CAIT representation, how far does it span?
The geographical limits of India,
right,
is our limitation.
So you cover every aspect, and that would take you even to an Andaman Nicobar or a Lakshadweep as much as the mainland.
And even in the rural areas as well.
So in the urban, semi-urban and rural,
rural
areas.
Areas.
So the coverage,
yes,
is total to that extent.
Absolutely.
This is extremely commendable. How do you keep the voice of all the traders in a unified way, considering when you are speaking to trade, to industry, as well as to government, how do you create a unified voice? How do you get the inputs of all of
these? before raising any issue with the government,
right,
we usually take inputs from our state chapters.
Right.
We have a national body.
Right.
Then we have state chapters.
Okay.
Then we have district chapters.
Right.
So likewise, it is a three-tier administrative system. So we take inputs,
right,
from district chapter,
right,
to our national executive body.
Right.
And thereby we build a consensus among our board members.
Sure.
And then we ask our research team,
sure,
to do research on the very subject.
Right.
And once the research paper is prepared,
right,
then we take the issue with the government.
Is that probably one of the big reasons why you have such a high hit rate? Even the new government formed by the Modi government in its second term, amongst the first announcements of the cabinet meetings was something for the traders in terms of pensions. So is that what really creates the effectiveness, the fact that this is a grassroots organization, well spread, highly represented and well researched subjects? Is that what really?
It is a well-known fact that SMEs in any country,
right,
are the real backbone of economy.
Absolutely.
So if we upgrade them,
right,
if we develop them,
sure,
if we give them better opportunities for conducting their business activities,
correct,
that is the core of economy of any country.
Absolutely.
The same principle applies to India as well.
Right.
So therefore, in its first cabinet meeting after re-election,
sure,
our Prime Minister Mr. Modi,
right,
he took certain logical decisions,
right,
for the welfare of the business community in the country,
right,
which we popularly call as SMEs.
Right. Now, one of your, you've had several ambitious programs and you only don't work on small ideas, as a matter of fact, and that's been your track record personally and that of the whole CAIT organization. One of the latest ones that you have taken is the resolve to digitize India and to digitize India's traders. Tell us a little about that and what's the big motivation for going in that direction?
Well, it's also a fact that the transformation,
right,
which is happening in global business,
right,
will have to travel in India also.
Absolutely.
If we have to keep pace with the global economy.
Right.
In India, the traders are basically conducting business,
right,
in their traditional way. Since last more than 400 years or 500 years or 600 years.
Right.
So they all are conducting business in traditional way.
Correct.
And we all know that now traditional way of doing business,
right,
will not be a survival point,
right,
for the trading community.
Sure.
And our Honorable Prime Minister, Mr. Narendra Modi,
right,
has given a slogan of Digital India.
Right.
So he has a futuristic vision,
sure,
about the development of India,
right,
And we want to be a core part of digital vision of Prime Minister Mr. Modi.
Right.
Therefore, we decided
right.
to digitalize our 70 million SMEs
right.
To keep in line with the mission of our Prime Minister Mr. Modi.
Right.
And because the way of conducting business is being changed. And rather, we are in a transformation stage.
Right.
From one system, we are moving ahead to a different system.
Sure.
So therefore, it is a transformation period.
Correct.
And if we do not digitalize our traders,
right.
we will not be in a position to leverage
right.
their capacities
right.
and their abilities.
Sure.
So therefore,
right.
the digitalization of the SMEs of India
right.
became in our mind
right.
and now it has become our motto and mission.
Absolutely. Now something that is a mission has to be achieved within a finite time frame, and the goal ahead of you is extremely it's a tall mountain, and we're trying to scale that tall mountain in quick time. How are you going about this from a strategic perspective? What's the blueprint or the roadmap that you have in terms of spreading this rapidly across the country and with so many establishments? What I've understood from our conversations is you're looking at a very ambitious number of at least well over 50,000 of these establishments and traders.
Rather 1 lakh.
Yes, so 100,000 establishments getting digitized in a short period of as little as 90 days. Can you tell us about that?
See, our aspirations for digitizing the SMEs
right.
got wings in Singapore.
Right.
Recently, one of our delegation visited Singapore
right.
and we studied the methodology
right.
of Singapore business and all that. Where we had conversation with the Monetary Authority of Singapore
right.
and Infocom Media Development Authority of Singapore
right.
and various other institutions.
Right.
And from there, our aspirations got wings.
That's right.
Because what Singapore is today,
right.
we want to convert India into a new Singapore
sure.
with full digitalization.
Sure.
That is why after our visit from Singapore,
right.
our board decided together
right.
and with the encouragement of Monetary Authority of Singapore
right.
and with the active collaboration of GlobalLinker
right.
and MasterCard,
sure.
we have designed a program
right.
that is called CAIT MasterCard GlobalLinker program,
right.
SMEs of India.
Right.
And under that program,
right.
we have asked all our state chapters
sure.
to take this initiative down the line,
right.
and several other government institutions
right.
Are also likely to join this movement.
Right.
And once it is a combined movement,
sure.
naturally in a short period of time,
right.
we would be able to reach the last mile of 70 million.
Sure.
But certainly the task is tough.
I can completely understand. And I know that your meetings both with the Chief FinTech Officer at the Monetary Authority of Singapore, with Mr. Supnendu Mohanty, as well as with the Indian High Commission, as well as the trade bodies that you met with in Singapore, and the rest of the organizations who were able to share a lot of their success stories, etc., had a very big impact. But also after your return, you've been able to socialize the topic or the subject and your plan with people in the Indian government, whether it's the Niti Aayog CEO Mr. Amitabh Kant or with the secretaries at the Ministry of Industry and Commerce, how's their reaction to your very ambitious plan?
Quite positive.
Right.
Quite positive.
And very supportive. And
very supportive.
That's great.
And I'm hoping a big support
sure.
from Government of India, because ultimately
right.
we are transforming the vision of our Prime Minister
sure.
into reality.
That's correct.
And having a progressive vision,
sure.
Not only of the Prime Minister,
right.
but even the concerned bureaucrats,
right.
they have also assured us full support.
That's excellent. No, that gives even greater tailwind to the whole program. Now, the big chapter over here is really for the success of this program. You've got a well-oiled machinery, you've got a great structure, but that is really the hands and the feet that make things happen for CAIT, for CAIT. But what about the involvement of the average trader who's represented by your national governing council? You had the opportunity to talk to them at length in the last 2 days. How has their reaction been to this very ambitious program and your goal of getting to 100,000? What is your level of reaching that goal of 100,000 SME traders in the next 90 odd days?
Well,
how do you feel about that?
Well, the entire fraternity of our executive governing council was very positive. And they all lauded our efforts.
Sure.
That we have taken such a big task.
Right.
After all, 70 million
right.
is not a small figure.
Absolutely.
And reaching out to those 70 million
right.
is certainly a tough job.
Sure.
But our 40,000 trade associations and federations
right.
will be the catalyst
sure.
for taking this initiative. Up to the last mile of 70
sure.
million.
Sure.
But as you rightly said, we had a National Governing Council conference.
Right.
So we have given them enough education
right.
and training about the program.
Sure.
And now they have become brand ambassadors.
Excellent.
So now after going from here,
right.
they will be independently
right.
Taking these programs
sure.
in their respective states
right.
as brand ambassadors
right.
of SMEs of Digital India and will work with local associations,
sure.
persuade the traders,
right.
rather encourage them, motivate them
sure.
to become digitized.
Sure.
And GlobalLinker has already has a big setup
sure.
and they will be in a position
right.
to convert our groundwork
right.
into real work.
Absolutely. That was my concluding question. For us on the side of GlobalLinker, it's been an absolute pleasure dealing with you personally, your committee or the core committee members, as well as the extended program from all the representatives of the various states, etc. What's your response to how GlobalLinker has played its part in this program and in?
See, I can say that during the conversation when head of startups.
Right.
Of HDFC Bank,
right.
Mrs. Smita Bhagat,
sure.
and Dr. Dinesh Tyagi,
right.
who is CEO of CSE,
right.
which is a department under Ministry of Electronics and Technology,
right.
they were also fascinated with the idea.
Right.
And they have rather on their own,
right.
they came forward
sure.
to join this movement.
That's correct.
So that means whatever GlobalLinker has taught to our traders
sure.
during last 2 days, our trade leaders.
Yes.
It has been conveyed to them in very clear terms.
Right.
And when they gone through the presentation,
right.
which we gave them.
Sure.
So it was a moment for them
right.
to join with this mega initiative.
Sure.
So likewise, I hope that with support of all these institutions
sure.
and I am hoping that in future
right.
many more will join this system
right.
and we will be able to convert people
sure.
in a reasonable shorter period
sure.
I mean it's not a it's not a movement for a year or so
sure.
It's a long term strategic journey
sure.
which may go for years together
sure.
so that is why we need to go ahead and that is our motive.
I want to ask you one last concluding question before we move on. From everything it seems like this is going to be a you know what was defined by even Nehruji about a tryst with destiny, but a changing moment or a life-defining moment as far as India and trade in India is concerned. How do you feel about the fact that you're in some ways trying to lead that charge. It's a uphill task clearly, but with great amount of confidence as well as energy. So how do you feel about the fact that some years later, some decades later, when people will look back in time, they will remember this moment where it all began?
Well, and you're right in the middle of it. Well, I'm pretty sure.
Right.
Number one, it will be a game changer.
Absolutely.
And I'm pretty sure
that
it will become an example
over
the globe.
A global case study.
Over the globe.
Right.
And people will write stories.
Right.
They will do research as to how CAIT was able to digitalize 70 million SMEs.
Right.
And here, you will appreciate that when we reach 70 million numbers, it is a job for so many years.
Sure.
By the time we will have 10 million more. So we have to go together.
Sure.
And not only the current SMEs, but even the startups, the would-be SMEs, we need to take them into consideration as well.
Sure.
So that we should go along with the time.
Absolutely. Well, thank you very much, Praveenji, for your time and for sharing your approach to this very, very large goal. On your behalf as well as my own behalf, I'd like to thank the other organizations that have come in and forward played a part in certainly in a large way, the MAS and IMDA organizations, the Business Sans Border program that not only digitizes the SMEs but also allows them to internationalize their business and the global opportunities open up. I think the Government of India and in all your interactions so far have been very, very positive.
Yes.
This is really not an effort of any one organization or individual. This has to spread like a movement. All the very best as you go through this. Extremely excited to partner with you in this great journey of ours. And you're right, I think this is going to change the complete landscape of this nation and how trade and commerce is done. On behalf of all the SME traders, I'm sure they're looking up to you for a lot of guidance and direction. But this is a great movement, and thank you for taking the time to talk to us about this. But all the very best as well in
thank
this
you.
Effort.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.